Automated workflows help you keep track of important dates and changes in Sheets, automate repetitive tasks, and gather essential input from collaborators. Automations consist of triggers, conditions, and actions. The trigger kicks off the workflow. It can be changes such as a status change, a new row added to the sheet, or even dates. The conditions determine the path the workflow takes. You can keep the conditions simple or make them complex. Finally, the action is what helps you save time and work efficiently. Actions include a Slack alert or email reminder, an update or approval request, moving a row, changing a cell value, locking a row, recording a date, and more. Let's set up our first automated workflow. As the marketing team manager, you need to be aware when a new campaign request is added to the sheet. On your sheet, select Automations. Keep in mind that each sheet can have up to 150 automations. Here, you can use a template or create from scratch. Let's create a new automation. Select Create from Scratch. Let's name the workflow Alert Marketing Manager about new requests. In the trigger dropdown, select when rows are added. Next, we'll leave the cell as any field. When you pick your trigger, avoid using cells containing cross-sheet formulas or cell links, as they don't trigger workflows that automatically change sheets. You can set the workflow run frequency, and in this case, let's leave it as when triggered. Next, let's add a condition. The more complex your sheet is, the more conditions you can add. Each workflow can have up to 100 blocks, and for complex condition blocks, the workflow evaluates the block in sequence from left to right. In this case, we want a condition that if the campaign type column is set to video marketing campaign, the video team lead gets notified instead. Select campaign type and then choose video marketing campaign. Now let's look at the actions. As the marketing team manager, you need to receive alerts if anything changes, but you also need to set an alert for the video team lead, following the condition we set earlier. First, let's follow the workflow and set the alert for the video team lead. Select Alert Someone. In the dropdown, choose Send to Contacts in a cell and select the video team lead. Once you choose the column name, you can add a personalized message and even include links to the sheet or specific fields. For this exercise, we'll leave it without a message. Now, let's set up the other alert. Select Otherwise, then Alert Someone. In the dropdown, choose Send to Specific People and choose your name. We'll also leave it without a message. Your workflow is now complete. Select Save. The workflow will now send you notification updates for all non-video projects, while the video team lead will receive notifications exclusively for video projects. Keep in mind that you can edit your workflow at any time. Just go to Edit. So, are you ready to start using workflows in Smartsheet? Check it out today or learn more in the Smartsheet Help Center. Thanks for watching.